We're on our way to Bonito in the Mato Grosso do Sul state of Brazil. It's the middle of winter here and it's bone dry. It reminds me a lot of the Orange Free State, a dry region of South Africa. Despite its arid appearance, Bonito is famous for waterfalls, underwater caverns, and crystal clear rivers teeming with fish. On arrival in the town, we decide to find a place to go swimming to escape the dry heat. All day trips around Bonito are booked through one of the many agencies in town. This is to control numbers and ensure sustainability. It's day two and we're on our way to Rio da Prata, which means the Silver River. Our guide tells us about the reforestation project at the reserve. After a short hike, we arrive at the source of Rio da Prata. The color of the water is incredible and the visibility is breathtaking. Our guide gives us a brief explanation about the do's and don'ts of swimming in the river. It's like getting inside a life-size version of the freshwater tropical aquariums that fascinated me as a child. But this is the real thing. Pass large schools of fish with names like Piraputanga and Corimba. The water in this river is like glass. We're lucky enough to see a caiman, a Brazilian relative of the crocodile. There are also large anacondas in these rivers known as sucuri, piranhas, and freshwater rays. After lunch, we head to our second location on the same farm.
We're here at the Lagoa Misteriosa. There's 179 steps to get there.
Lagoa Misteriosa is a sinkhole leading down into a series of tunnels of unknown depth. It's been explored until 220 meters and is considered one of Brazil's deepest underwater caves. The water here is incredibly clear due to the fact that it's filtered through limestone and a high magnesium content gives it its otherworldly blue color. As you descend, you can get a feel for this place's awesome depth. When you look up towards the surface, you can actually make out the trees through the crystal clear water. Diving here is something completely different to anything I've experienced before. My mind starts to wonder about the raw power of the natural events that created this place. thinks it's time to head to the surface. But first, we make a safety stop so excess nitrogen can disperse from our bodies. Our time in Bonito has come to an end, but the unique beauty of the region and the high level of preservation will leave a lasting impact on us. We discovered that its magical reputation is well deserved, and I would return in a heartbeat.